Hey guys, good morning everyone. Welcome back to the online class. As you know that yesterday we have completed adjectives comparison, not completed, but yes, we have seen some of the important points of this chapter, right? Hope you have remembered it. And before starting the next topic today, we will take a recap of what we have seen yesterday. Okay, so yesterday whatever the things we have seen, we have seen comparison of five types of at the higher level, at the lower level, at the same level, at the highest level, at the lowest level. Yeah, we have also seen adjectives 3 degree, that was positive, comparative and superlative, in which we have seen what is positive degree, what is comparative degree, what is superlative degree, right? So we have seen positive degree. It is used to describe a single thing or a person or in comparison that are of the same level. Okay, in comparative degree we have seen that it is used for doing comparison between the quality or the quantity of two things or person which are unequal. Yeah. And the superlative degree we have seen, which is used when one thing or person is singled out in a comparison that involves several kinds, means among all of the things or person we are comparing them to a, means a single thing or person is compared between among all the persons or things. Okay, so these are the things we have seen yesterday, and today we will see types of comparative forms. Today we will see what types of comparative forms. Usually single syllable words take er and est. Single syllable, have you heard about this syllable? Yeah, I have taught you this in New Pathways, I think chapter number 1. Okay, so in that we have seen syllable. What is this syllable? Syllable means when a word is divided into 2 or 3 or 4 or even in a single. When single syllable, that we cannot break that word, we cannot break that words, or we if we have means there will be only one means how through which we can separate them. Okay. Breaking of the words, and there will be 1, 2, 3, there are many. Okay, so first one is that single syllable words take er and est. Example, big, bigger, biggest. Here single, if we will break this bigger, bigger, biggest, right? So when we are able to break the words, okay, they are said to be syllable. Here by adding er and est, we can break a word and they are said to be single syllable. So like this, for example, we are learning here types of comparative forms, in which first one we have seen the examples are big, bigger, biggest. The second example is thin, thinner, thinnest. Okay, so these are the rules which you have to remember. Okay, types of comparative forms, how many types of comparative forms are there? They are, the first one is single syllable. Now the second one we will see, the same holds true for a lot of double syllable words. Now we will see double syllable words. Okay, example, happy, happier, happiest. Narrow, narrower, narrowest. Means here we can break the words in two parts. In two parts, that is called a double syllable. Syllable, I have told you, when we are able to break the words in 2, 3 or many more. Okay, so here we will do a comparative. We will form a comparative forms by with the double syllables and by adding er or est, right? So here the examples are happy, happier, happiest, narrow, narrower, narrowest. Okay, However, many double-syllable words retain their positive forms and take more or less before them. Yeah, some of the words which are not breakable, in which we are not able to add ers, er or est, they take what? They take more or less. They take more or less. Okay, now let's see. Examples are, as a pet, a dog is more faithful. We are not adding faithfuler or faithfulest. We are adding more, or we can add less also. So here, as a pet, a dog is more faithful than a cat. Okay. She is more hardworking. Here also, we do not add er or est, like hard worker, hard workers. No, that would be like no. That the answer will not be correct. We can add more or less for making the comparison forms. Okay. So what here it is given that they cannot be we cannot do a syllable here in a words. So how we can make the forms? We can make their adding more or less to their positive forms. We can make them by adding more or less to the positive forms. Adjectives with more than two syllables usually form their comparative degree with more or less. Adjectives with more than two syllables means when there are more than two syllables usually forms their comparative degree with more or less. Means here what, when we are able to break a word in two, means it should be a double syllable, then we are taking what? More or less to their positive forms. More or less to their positive form. Now see examples. Difficult. We cannot say difficult. Difficult. This will be like wrong. It's absolutely wrong. How we can make them correct comparison? We can make their correct comparison by adding more or less to the positive forms. Okay. The present and past participles of verbs used as adjectives, right? This one we have seen also, that the past participle and present participles, they are the verb forms and they are used for as adjectives. They are used as adjective. We have seen verb as adjectives now in adjective chapter. Yeah, so that will be the adjective forms, and they will build their comparative degree with more or less. When we are when present participles and past participles, we are using them to comparing between two things, or we are using them to compare something, then we will add more or less with present participles and past participles. Okay, here it is some examples. Concerned, we will never say concerner, like this will be absolutely wrong. We will say more concerned and less concerned. Worn, more worn, less worn. Cooked, more cooked, less cooked. Okay. The comparative degree of adjectives is usually followed by than to make comparison. Yeah. We do a comparative, means in comparative degree. Of adjective, we usually take what? We usually take than to compare, to make comparison. We usually take than to make comparison. Like we have seen yesterday, Ruchi is taller than Neeta, right? For example, I'm giving you than. We are using than when we are using comparative degree, and we are doing comparison between two persons or thing. We use than for making comparison between them. However, the following are exceptions to this rule, and some exceptions are also which you have to learn it. Okay, exceptions are here: junior to, senior to, inferior to, superior to, preferable to. Okay, these are the exceptions. I think they will not take more or less, or they will not change their form. They won't be able to syllable, okay, even single or double. So they are the exceptions, and they are used with two, okay. We cannot say more junior than or more senior than, just as we cannot use more better. More is not needed because these words are already in comparative degree. This word junior, senior, inferior, superior, preferable, these are already in comparative degree, and that they are already comparing between two things or qualities. This comparative degree of adjective do not take more or less before them, okay. It's worth nothing that a superlative term is possible with these terms, okay. Natalia is the junior most officer in the platoon, okay. Abhas is the senior most employee in the company, and we will make superlative term with these terms, okay. We can add some superlative forms like most or least by this comparative form of junior, senior, inferior, superior, preferable, okay. We like this, we can use it. Natalia is the junior most, Abhas is the senior most, okay. The adjective good, bad and far are special cases with the following comparative and superlative degree. Yeah. Good, bad or far, these are the special one, okay. Their comparative and superlative degrees are following that: good, better, best. We can't say gooder, goodest, this is absolutely wrong. So good, better, best. Bad, worse, worst. Far, farther ya further. Farthest ya furthest, okay. This you have to remember it. Adjectives that take more or less to build their comparative form take the most or the least to build their superlative form. Yes, when we are using more or less to a adjective, in an adjective, then that will be their comparative form, but for making their superlative form, we will change more to most and less to least, okay. So active, less active, the least active. Okay, don't forget to add the, because yesterday I have told you why we are using the in superlative form. We are using the in the superlative form for specifying the things or person. Important, more important, yeah, the most important will be the superlative form. Concern, less concern is comparative form, and the least concern is the superlative form, okay. So here we are ending. So whatever the rules we have seen in types of comparative forms, we have seen that single syllable words take ER and EST. Yes, they are taking what? Big, bigger, biggest. They're just, we are adding ER and EST by doing comparison. First is that. Second, double syllable also, when we are changing their forms, like happy, happier, happiest, okay. Third, in the case when some of the words which do not take means they cannot be broke into syllable, so their positive forms, and they take more or less with their positive forms, okay. Fourth, adjectives with more syllables, they use more or less to their comparative degree, okay. Fifth, with the present and past participle, we use more or less, okay. To compare comparative degree of adjectives, we use than to compare, to make comparison, okay. And some exceptions were also that junior to, senior to, inferior to, superior to, and preferable to, okay. And a superlative term which is possible with these terms, some of the superlative forms with these exceptions: junior most or less, senior most or less, inferior most or less, superior most or less, preferable less or more, okay. Like this we can make their superlative forms. and some of the special cases are also like good, bad, far, and many more will be there. You will be able to study all that. And the last one, we have seen rule adjective that take more or less. They form their superlative by changing in more to most, less to least. Got it? So these are the important points of this chapter. Rules are there, types of comparative forms. You have to study about positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree, and you have to study this following comparison types. Okay, so this is all about this chapter, and this exercise is given here also. One exercise is given here. Okay, and the last exercise, let's revise, it is here. What you have to do in this, just you have to change the form according to the sentences, according to the things what is given at the end of the sentence, directed, as it is directed, you have to do that. First one is done for you, that the red dress was pretty. Then you have to change this into comparative degree. What you will say? The red dress was prettier than other. Okay, just you have to take slight change you have to do, and you will be able to form any of the forms what is directed in the brackets. Okay, second one is also, he is wealthier than all other businessmen in our city. Change to superlative degree. What we do in superlative degree, we do that we have to compare a single person or thing among everyone. So what you will say here, he is the, don't forget to add the, you have to add the with the superlative degree. He is the wealthiest businessman, okay, in our city. He is the wealthiest businessman in our city. That's it. Okay. And the Pacific is the largest of all the oceans. You have to change this to comparative degree. What you will say? The Pacific Ocean is larger than all the oceans. Okay, like this you have to complete all the exercises. Okay, so please complete your books and please go through this rules, forms, study that all, and study definitions and the types also. Okay, so this is all about the chapter. Have a nice day to all. Go through the video completely. Okay.